I want to look at a verse from the Bible. It's Psalm chapter 97 verse 10, which says, "Let those who love the Lord hate evil, for he guards the lives of his faithful ones and delivers them from the hand of the wicked." I want to look at four words. Number one, well, what is it? Is it the mushy, cozy, nicey-feely sort of love we see everywhere in the world today? Or is it the total dedication, unswerving loyalty? I suspect it's the latter. Number two, hey, what is it? Is it a throwaway phrase? Or is it not wanting anything to do with what has been talked about? I suspect it's the latter. Number three, guards. It's not some wimpy, half-hearted token gesture, but all-consuming, all-powerful guard. That's a lot different to how we might look at it. Number four, delivers. It's not just resist, and at the end of the day, we thank God for survival. He delivers us from, he delivers us. It's a physical act of victory, and it isn't us who's doing it, it's God. We can thank God for the victory. I thank God that he's the one fighting my battles. So what do I have to do? What do we have to do? We have to love the Lord our God and hate evil. That sounds pretty simple, but we're talking about total dedication, unswerving loyalty with regard to love, and total dedication and unswerving hatred of everything that stands opposite to God's purposes. It's not wanting anything to do with it. We need to hate the things that are against God in our lives with passion, and God will do the rest. So let's look at that verse again. Let those who love the Lord hate evil, for he guards the lives of his faithful ones and delivers them from the hand of the wicked. We love the Lord our God with total dedication. We hate evil with equal but opposite dedication, for he guards our lives with a total guard over it. He delivers them from the hand of the wicked. We have the victory. Amen.